This week, one of the greatest men I've ever known, Robert James Morella, passed away at age 62. He was celebrated and beloved worldwide as legendary superstar Gorilla Monsoon. To his friends, he was known simply as Gino. Gino had a gorilla-sized passion for life, this business, and more importantly, the people in it. Behind the scenes, he was a cornerstone in the World Wrestling Federation. Our thoughts and prayers go out to his wife, Maureen, and his entire family. With great sadness and heavy hearts, we say goodbye to Gino, a very special man who lived a very special life.
We, of course, would like to extend our condolences also to the Morella family. We are definitely all going to miss Gorilla a whole lot.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Hensville, Pennsylvania, weighing 245 pounds, the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman.
We are set to get hardcore as metal begins. We welcome you to the broadcast. Terry Taylor, Kevin Kelly ringside, counting down the days to No Mercy. Stone Cold Steve Austin plans on walking in the challenger, but walking out with the gold.
Yeah, and Triple H says there's no way in hell that he's going to let Stone Cold take his title.
We'll find out what happens.
His opponent from Plymouth, Ohio, weighing 246 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation, hardcore.
Al Snow to defend the hardcore title here against the lethal weapon, Steve Blackman. Of course, later on in the hour, we'll see the Godfather going up one-on-one against the Big Boss Man. And the Big Show will make his metal debut, taking on Chaz, Gangrel in action, and a whole lot more as Steve Blackman extending the right hand into the facial region of Al Snow.
Would that be the right hand of friendship?
No, sir.
Blackman, they say he's a silent assassin. He doesn't say much, but those hands and feet speak volumes.
Al Snow's going to have to take it outside, try to get it nasty.
Or Blackman right in front of us. I would prefer that he stand a little closer to you, Kevin.
In our laps goes Al Snow.
Good Lord, what a dive!
See, that's the stuff that people don't understand how dangerous that dive over the top is. And I have a feeling one of those people might be Al Snow.
And, of course, no clear example of just how dangerous this is. And this past week when Chaz, Derek Johnson, was seriously injured this past Tuesday in a match at the Nassau Coliseum. He dislocated two vertebrae in his neck and then underwent surgery to stabilize it and realign his spine. Now, doctors say they're working hard to help Chaz. However, a prognosis for recovery won't be known for days. And, of course, our thoughts and prayers go out to Chaz, his fiance, and his entire family.
Something like that, Kevin, it really lets you know how dangerous this can be, and for kids not to try this at home.
Absolutely, and now we're getting up close and personal with Steve Blackman. His head getting up close and personal with our announced position. Oh, man, hard right hand. Boy, certainly Stone Cold Steve Austin can't wait to get to No Mercy. You know he's not only looking to regain the World Wrestling Federation Championship, but Terry also looking for revenge.
Yeah, when you think about the message sent by Triple H by smashing that bag, and we don't want to go into a lot of detail. We all know what happened. Man, what a message sent to Stone Cold, and then Stone Cold, slight retaliation. What's going to happen Monday in Atlanta?
Well, there's going to be over 35,000 fans as Raw is live from the Georgia Dome, and you know that Stone Cold Steve Austin will be there, and he's going to be coming after Triple H. Folks, this is a hardcore championship match. All of this is legal right here.
and it certainly now appears to play into the lethal weapon Steve Blackman's hands. You see the martial arts skill, and Al Snow is feeling that skill across his front and his back.
Well, I don't know why Al Snow, I mean, must have a death wish. This guy is a masochist. He enjoys pain, and I wonder psychologically what that means to his opponents.
Well, certainly Steve Blackman has been doling out the pain as of late, and to a rather unlikely suspect, Terry, 2 weeks ago during an interview you were conducting.
Yeah, Jim Dodson, head of security. I never thought I'd interview Jim, but right...
Oh, gosh!
Jim Dodson was standing next to me. Blackman knocks over the whole set, puts the boots, I'm glad, to the right person, which would have been Dodson.
Yeah, well, that goes back, of course, to Unforgiven, when Steve Blackman and Jim Dodson first crossed paths. And look at the looks of Dodson. He's not somebody you want to cross paths with. And Al Snow is crossing paths. That's actually Metal Pan and Stick there. Meeting of the minds.
Well, Al Snow, how would you scout, if you were an athlete, Kevin, I mean, stretch it a little bit. If you were an athlete, how would you scout somebody like Al Snow?
I'm not quite sure, but Steve Blackman is certainly finding out that hardcore may not be the way to go with Al Snow. And every time Blackman goes back to the martial arts roots that he comes in with, he's successful.
Kevin, there's an old saying, don't ever bring something to a fight you don't want used against you. And I think Al Snow's starting to figure that out, too.
Oh, almost had him.
Wow, what a gut check.
Boy, the first near fall of the match, and it was almost the real fall there. Blackman nearly walking away with the hardcore title. And you gotta wonder, will Stone Cold Steve Austin walk away with the World Wrestling Federation Championship at No Mercy next Sunday, live on pay-per-view?
Gosh!
DDT! And certainly now, Al Snow appears to be in the driver's seat.
Boy, I think all Al Snow has to do is roll over, get his weight up on the shoulders, too.
Wow, Blackman, tough as nails.
Well, I'll tell you what, I don't know how these guys kick out anymore. Not that I ever did kick out anything, but what toughness these WWF superstars have.
Usually most Terry Taylor matches featured the left leg extended high into the air. Shoulders really? Flat on the mat.
You never have to worry about my shoulders getting any hair.
And look
right
at,
off.
Boy, look at Al Snow elevating himself into the corner, using his body as a battering ram. And all the instruments of plunder you see from the steel chairs and all, it's all legal, it's hardcore. Oh, 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 oh. Coming right at you, folks. Al Snow just got drilled.
What in the world is it gonna take to end this matchup, for gosh sakes?
It certainly is very brutal here as we kick off the Hour of Metal. Later on, we'll see Gangrel in action. We'll also see the Godfather tangling with the Big Boss Man. Baseball slide. Of course, the baseball playoffs are in high gear. Wonder if Al Snow is rooting on the Cleveland Indians, being from Lima, Ohio and all.
Are the Dolphins in those playoffs?
That would be football, Terry.
Big sports fan.
And speaking of sports, it appears as if we're about to get a little bowling action.
Wait a minute. Uh-oh. Kevin, I don't like the looks of this as far as the view from Steve Blackman.
You got to make sure your fingers are dry, Terry. Get a good grip. Oh!
I think Blackman has a good grip right now.
Not exactly the way Steve Blackman saw this one going, but Al Snow now, I think this match is ripe for the taking.
You think when Blackman was in the dojo, the martial arts studio, learning all those moves, he thought somebody would be rolling a bowling ball into his groin area?
I'm sure that it never even came up for discussion.
How do you defend against that?
I'll tell you, as Al Snow is setting up this table,
I think it's the frame.
Look out from behind, because Steve Blackman, oh boy, just missed. That would have been all she wrote for Al Snow.
What? Could this get any more wild?
This is out of control. The Hardcore Championship up for grabs.
Unbelievable that Al Snow is not somewhere in South America after all these shots he's taken.
And now Blackman placing Al Snow across the table. And I would say that this is about all she wrote. Poor Mr. Blackman still feeling the remnants of the
bowling ball. Is that a strike? I think it was a split. 7-10 split.
Blackman now going, wait a minute, look at Jim Dodson on the far side.
Jim Dodson starting up the ring apron. Distraction.
Oh, gosh.
Is that a pinfall with his...
Okay, it's all good.
Everybody watch.
Jim Dodson interjects himself. Al Snow's still a hardcore champion. And speaking of hardcore, the king of hardcore, Mankind, is the Rock and Sock.
connection on its way out. We'll talk more about that and how it relates to Raw and how it relates to No Mercy as the hour continues here in Metal. Still to come on WWF Metal. Triple H uses good old JR to send a message to Stone Cold. The highlights from Raw. Plus, the Godfather and his lovely ladies will be here. He takes on the Big Boss Man. And up next, the Gothic One. Gangrel will be in action. Stay with us. Metal continues. And saying to himself, why, Terry, did I ever sign this contract to take on Gangrel here on Metal?
I look at that Gangrel, Kevin, and I see that blood Ooh. Running out of his mouth, those teeth. It frightens me. Another thing I think I'd be frightened if I was the Bulldog, after throwing that trash container, who would you look for first to make the big comeback? Would it be Shane McMahon, the hothead, or would it be Tess, the fiancé?
Well, certainly the British Bulldog not only disgraced himself in his own country last weekend at a special event in the UK, but he's also really set himself in the line of fire with the McMahon family. Of course, Stephanie McMahon, as we know now, is currently in a hospital, and she is, well, from what we understand, suffering, well, from amnesia. And there are periods of time where she doesn't even recognize her own fiance. And because of that, folks, the wedding plan between Test and Stephanie McMahon has for now been postponed. Oh, man, right across the shoulder blades.
Can you imagine the emotional upheaval in Test's life when he knows that the person he loves doesn't even recognize his face?
That's got to be very troublesome for Test. But certainly the Bulldog is going to have some troubles. You know the people's champ, the great one, The Rock, cannot wait to get to the Gund Arena in Cleveland, Ohio.
And go one on one. Sorry, I just had to do it.
Inferno Kid now beginning to mount a bit of a comeback. Certainly The Rock will tangle with the British Bulldog. All part of the huge card at No Mercy next Sunday, live on pay-per-view. Oh, sunset flip, upset time. No, sir, just a two.
Boy, Gangrel all upside down, gets upset. Bang! Impaler!
Center of the ring, doesn't even bother to hook the leg, but this one is over. And now look at this.
Here is your winner, Gangrel.
Like rabid animals, Matt Jeff Hardy, the new brute circling on the kill. But are they circling in on Terry? $100,000 in the managerial services of the Terry Invitational. Still to come here on WWF Metal, Chaz has been looking for a little help of late, but I doubt he'll get it when he tangles with the Big Show.
And up next, the Big Balboshi's made the Brahma Bull angry. Highlights as these two superstars battle on SmackDown.
This week, WWF Metal is brought to you by the motor oil that provides maximum protection. Castrol GTX, drive hard.
And by Burger King, when you have it your way, it just tastes better. And by the Air Force. You have plans. The Air Force can help you get them off the ground. Visit airforce.com.
What will happen to the Rocket Sock Connection? Well, we're sure to find out this Monday, live on Raw, when over 35,000 fans pack the Georgia Dome, live in Atlanta for Raw. And still to come here on WWF Metal, Triple H has a message for Stone Cold and uses a rattlesnake to send it. The highlights from SmackDown.
All right, Kevin, you ready?
Yeah.
It's the Big Show! He takes on Chaz. Battle continues.
Well,
Kevin, Big Show is on a roll. This guy is so big, handcuffs don't fit him. Chaz ought to know how handcuffs feel after his treatment of Mariana lately.
Just how huge, how enormous the Big Show is this past Thursday on SmackDown. The Big Boss Man tried to handcuff the Big Man, and those handcuffs, that was like a pinky ring. Forget about it.
You have no idea, people, how big the Big Show is until you stand up close to him. There's no sheet around him or anything.
Well, Chaz has certainly been persona non grata around the World Wrestling Federation locker rooms as of late.
What does that mean?
That means he is not welcome because of, the treatment that he is being accused of from his former girlfriend, Mariana. As of now, we have no proof, though, Terry.
She gets caught with Sean Stasiak, and Chaz is the bad guy.
Well, again, for what we've seen Mariana sporting recently, well, some people would say yes. But again, there's been no proof. As of late, of course, Chaz has had his problems trying to get a fair shake, it appears, from some WWF officials. In fact, the last time we saw Chaz in action, last Sunday night on Heat, he got flattened by Viscera, with the referee turning a blind eye every time Viscera broke the rules.
Two sides of that. I think Vince McMahon has made the referees here power drunk.
Power drunk?
Yeah, if they're going to let Chaz, without having a court of law to hear what happened, hear his side, that's not right.
Well, Chaz going back to basics, tries the single leg takedown. Ooh. Nothing happening. Waist lock, trying some drop kicks, nothing doing there.
And the other half of that is,
good Lord.
I cannot believe what we just saw. I was going to say, it takes guts. Chaz coming into a building knowing everybody vilifies him and hates his guts. And I'm talking about the locker room. He came in here, and what an elevation by the Big Show. And ain't Big Show talking trash.
Well, there you see Chaz getting desperate now, avoiding what was certain to be the choke slam and a defeat. Really getting into the eyes of the Big Show, doing anything he can.
I think if it was a fight between me and the Big Show, I'd do the same thing. How do you take a man like that down?
We'll find out, of course, this Sunday on Heat what Chaz has to offer. He'll battle Steve Blackman, and also on Heat Deja Video. X-Pac and Shane McMahon at WrestleMania 15, plus Y2J makes his Heat debut. Chris Jericho and Curtis Hughes against the Dudley Boys. And look out, nosebleed time for Chaz. The high elevation on the chokeslam. It's over.
Well, it's the biggest winner of the Big Show.
Yeah, Terry, I agree with you. I think the Big Show has turned a corner. And I think very bright days are ahead in this man's future.
If this guy figures out he's 7 feet 500 pounds,
nobody's safe. Big Show had his problems with the Boss Man this past Thursday on SmackDown. And still to come here on WWF Metal, we will see the Big Boss Man in action, looking to dish out a little hard time, this time to the Godfather, who you know, it ain't easy.
And up next, Triple H sends a message to the Rattlesnake with a Rattlesnake highlights from Raw and SmackDown.
WWF No Mercy is presented by Legacy of Kain, Soul Reaver by Eidos Interactive. No Mercy is next Sunday, October 17th, and is available exclusively on pay-per-view. WWF Metal is brought to you by JVC Kaboom Box, so loud it hurts.
And by Skittles, bite-sized candies, taste the rainbow of fruit flavors.
And by WWF Raw Magazine. Check out the October issue featuring the People's Champ, The Rock, available at newsstands everywhere.
Know what's not easy about this.
Some days it's easier than others. Oh, wait a minute. I thought he was only going to come out with a pair. But instead...
Or two pairs.
It's a full house. Godfather's on Metal.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from the Red Light District, weighing 320 pounds, the Godfather.
Of course, Godfather always having a good time, always got the ladies with him, and I'm fascinated. Good Lord. I'm fascinated.
fascinated
with her?
No, I'm fascinated by what Godfather would think about Jeff Jarrett and this whole situation surrounding the World Wrestling Federation Good Housekeeping match, the Intercontinental title on the line at No Mercy next Sunday live on pay-per-view. Do you think the Godfather could secretly be pulling for the ninth wonder of the world?
I think so, because let's be honest, Godfather smiles, treats the ladies nicely, they have fun, and I'm sitting here next to you.
Oh, I hate my life.
Well, certainly Jeff Jarrett hasn't been treating anybody nicely as of late.
I'm going to get up in the ring, Kev.
Sit down.
No!
Sit down.
I got to get in there and boogie.
I think probably you and the Godfather could work on some negotiations. I bet one of those women could take you.
I'd probably throw me back for being too small.
Like fishing.
It's time, once again, for everybody to come aboard the
Hoo Train!
His opponent, from Paul County, Georgia, weighing 305 pounds, the Big Boss Man.
From it ain't easy to hard time, Big Boss Man on the scene.
Boy, this got ugly in a hurry.
Big Boss Man certainly had problems with the Big Show. We saw this past Thursday on SmackDown. I got a feeling the Boss Man's in a foul mood, tangled with the Godfather.
The Boss Man is all business, and he isn't afraid to use that nightstick on anybody. And you got to know Godfather knows that.
Well, you know, we were talking about Jeff Jarrett before. What about Jeff Jarrett this past Thursday on SmackDown, Terry, introducing a mud wrestling ring and actually fooling Ivory and Miss Kitty into getting in there and competing.
He also threw May and Ule in there. Total humiliation for all the women in the WWF because Jeff Jarrett thinks they ought to be in the kitchen.
Hey.
Ooh, man. Boss Man not even waiting to hear the offer from the Godfather before opening up a straight right hand.
Kevin, I'm going to go help the girls.
Yeah, that's exactly what they need. Look at the Boss Man. Folks, to make our point complete, China will battle Jeff Jarrett. First ever World Wrestling Federation Good Housekeeping match at No Mercy next Sunday live on pay-per-view. Any type of domestic item possible will be legal in that match with the Intercontinental title on the line. It is a first for the World Wrestling Federation.
Yeah, and what would be a first and probably the most humiliating thing to ever happen to Jeff Jarrett is to be defeated by a woman.
Jeff Jarrett believes that women have no place in the ring, that they should be home, cooking, cleaning, taking care of the children.
Up with that.
I don't know if the Godfather will be able to have any children after Boss Man takes care of business.
Boy, have you seen the new EMT? Maybe she should come out and ice. Oh, never mind.
Never mind at all as Godfather's ladies scurry away from the Cobb County, Georgia lawman.
Notice there's no wasted motion by Boss Man. Doesn't leave his feet a lot. Great low center of gravity and just uses every part of his body well.
And of course, the Boss Man with perhaps the crispest punch in the industry.
That right hand, to quote a warm, friendly friend of mine, is scintillating.
And look at this now. Two gloved hands right into the eyes of the Godfather. Boy, Raw is War, folks, live this Monday, Georgia Dome, Atlanta. Over 35,000 fans expected to be on hand with the rattlesnake, you know, looking for revenge. Oh! There's that right hand right into the mouth of the Godfather.
I live in Atlanta.
Beautiful city. Wait a minute. Boss Man just gets to two, and I know everybody in Atlanta is talking about the World Wrestling Federation.
They really are. I mean, excitement is high. All the WWF superstars excited about being there, and what a show it's going to be Monday night.
I've got a little bit of a heavy feeling in my heart. I think we're about to see the end of the Rock and Sock connection. I got a feeling total implosion this Monday. That's just my gut feeling after everything that's gone down the past couple of weeks between The Rock and Mankind. Oh, man.
That hurts me all the way to my soul.
Well, lateral press, Boss Man.
Rock and Sock, Kelly Taylor, come on.
This match continues, folks. Stay with us. We're back on Metal, and the assault on the Godfather continues at the hands of the Big Boss Man. And finally, the Godfather able to mount a comeback.
Well, I tell you what, Boss Man's been all over the Godfather like a bad fit coat.
Boy, right now, some offense mounted here by Godfather. The momentum picks up. Godfather's had enough. Huge body slam by the Godfather. Wow, that is a load from the Boss
Certainly, folks, X-Pac and Kane have had their problems with the Acolyte. Wait a second, leg drop, two, almost had him. And the point I wanted to make about X-Pac and Kane, I'm really concerned about that tandem, Terry. It appears as if X-Pac, to me, has got a little bit of an inferiority complex happening.
Yeah, you've got to have total confidence in yourself and your partner. And right now, the confidence factor with X-Pac and himself is not there.
I've got to wonder if the Acolytes are going to look to take advantage of that in a four-corner elimination match at No Mercy next Sunday. Wait a minute. Boss Man's got that nightstick in his hands as Godfather's revving up the engines, throwing a little coal in the fire. Oh! Knocked right into the throat. And unfortunately for the Godfather, Boss Man was very stealth about that. Referee Jim Corderas never saw it. The three count is told, and the Boss Man's going to sneak out of town, not on the train, but with a controversial victory.
That's a huge victory for the Boss Man after fighting Thursday night, the Big Show. And what's... You got the win, that's enough. Those are the same handcuffs that Thursday night did not fit the Big Show's wrist. Uh-oh. These girls don't understand, oh, Kevin, they don't understand what danger they're in.
I like it. They're here for a good time. They're not here for any of this. Certainly the Boss Man is all business. And, well, wait a minute now. This is really uncalled for.
Boy, and I don't see any of the girls going to help. Not that I blame them.
I don't think she's in any danger, Terry. I just think Big Boss Man's really going out of his way.
He's making a point.
Proving a point to everybody. Folks, we are heading to Roy's War live from the Georgia Dome. We invite you all to join us. 9